Hello everyone, in May 2001, a new version of the navigation program from the TomTom company was released, VAT 3.017. I hasten to introduce you to it. I will leave the download link in the description of the video and... This means there will be a file like this. TomTom GPS Car Navigation 3.017 right there. In the meantime, this version is for Android, and so let's start installing. Install the application. It is a stable free version, and it is free for the entire service life. Innovations are mainly in the program settings, also updating maps immediately and information on the route is given more fully at a sufficient distance from the starting point. Well, it's also easier to plan a route with stops at several points. Well, this program has received a number of other improvements. So she stopped. There appeared a handle like this, TomTom, let's launch, that is the language. The interface is multilingual and Russian. That is, depending on the language of the device, that language is installed. We allow GPS here is a brief description of offline maps, online quality routes notifications in real time, and weekly updates and no annoying ads. Navigation at the highest level on unfamiliar junctions and exits. This application is available free of charge as a trial application to give you the opportunity to become familiar with the application's features before purchasing a subscription. Ready? Means can this application send your information if necessary before preparing the application to receive cards? Location included and accordingly maps. Depending on our location, we will add all maps of the world. I change Europe, I am interested in. Belarus, click download. Shorter route with ferry crossings. If you are going to use ferry crossings, agree yes. If no, choose no principle. I'll set it to yes and wait for the map to load. So the map was loaded. They offer to install voices. We don't have voices installed. Go to settings and sounds and warnings. Voice download voice for Russian language. Lena Ona Lad download voice. Milena. The voice has loaded. We can load the voices, and so the program is ready for use. I want to note that this is what we do if we install the TomTom program on our device for the first time, if we had some previous version. Then before installing a new version, you need to remove the old one. And also, if you had planned routes and routes in the old version, then it's easier to register an account in that one. And when we install the new version and log into our account, all previous settings are transferred to the new program automatically. This is the program interface. This icon here shows our current location. This one switches the sound, only a warning, the sound is muted, or the sound is turned on completely. This means the search line on the left can decrease, increase, and map again, return to your location and press search so that we see the points of the parking lot and parking further gas stations we can choose further. Restaurants, cafes, and so on. Besides these, there are also subcategories we can choose from. There are a lot of them here. Airports, gas stations, let's say an airport. Distance, that is, this is a search by pinpoints. And a category overview too. Very large of all possible points, then, as usual, we can simply enter a search at. This way. We can click go, we can add a place to make it a departure point and search near this point, that is, we can add intermediate coordinates, click go and the route is calculated immediately and they suggest that we turn right a little, then at the end of the road turn left. Several routes. We can finish. Yes, let's say if we stop the navigation search, we have already added a destination and we press go and we can choose other routes that are marked on the map and which we need. More like it, that is, different roads respectively and different. Turn right, then turn left at the end of the road. Yes, with this everything seems to be clear. Here we can add a stop. Let's say 1 hour and 5 minutes for arrival at the destination. Let's say on the highway, I want to add a stop here further along different routes, and that is along. Here are alternative routes. This is how you can navigate using navigation. Turn right, then turn left at the end of the road. There is also a detour to the obstacle, change the type of route. Fast, short, in short, optimal, exciting, cycling, walking. We can look further. Turn right, then turn left at the end of the road. Turn left, then turn right. We can too. Turn right. Here we can choose the preferred order of stops. That is, the route is built quite conveniently. At the end of the road, turn right at 34. Soviet. Here's a message about the speed camera. That is, we can mark where we see. where we'll see the cameras, so let's go through the settings so the search is the same as what we looked at, it's clear and... By the way, the voice search microphone or points by works and select either the name of the route and... This is a keyboard call, we can then add a house, we can add the address of the house, add our own, add a job. Location here we will have recent ones that we have marked favorite places, also means home, work, latest destinations, contacts. If addresses are added to our contacts, they will automatically appear. Photos too. Well, that's what he said. You can activate synchronization with My Drive. Safely save and restore your measured places, that is, their registration and all settings will be saved, further parking, gas station service, and TomTom, and speed camera traffic. Synchronize your location across all devices. Online search. Improve search results with data from the web. And online routes. Calculate your route online for faster and more accurate results. Again, all this through TomTom services. You need to register an account. TomTom Labs here, experimental functions, in this case scale bar, further support, and... What's new in this version? Look at the splash screen and the user manual, but the user manual in Russian is not there. But what's new is described here. What are the improvements in this version? Further setting here, we can configure display maps. Here we can download maps of those that we are missing. Day and night colors should be switched. Automatically show useful addresses on the map. We can also show the name of the current street and contacts on the map. Further information about arrival will be shown in this case. The remaining distance can also be the remaining time or both. Also either the destination or the next stop that we have set the route panel that we can display, we can make the panel large. Parking, gas stations, rest areas, toll areas, ferries, and car transporters. Next, the orientation scale. Configure in this menu item, map orientation. Also, zooming in during the indicated instructions is a great big detail when needed. The color scheme is also customizable. In this case, the default is sea surf. Card color. The usual one is worth it, you can turn on the beta style. Route planning is also customizable, preferred type fast, you can choose short, shorter, optimal, exciting cycling, and walking, that is navigation. For all types of movements except freight transport, we can also turn on a toll road if possible. Unpaved roads, lanes for vehicles with passengers, highways, tunnels. We can include ferries, car transport wagons, and tunnels. Route manually or automatically, or do not change the route if the road is not closed, if a better route is discovered. That is, we will be asked. Well, and so on. Vehicle profile here. By engine type, either an internal combustion engine, an electric motor, or an electric motor, and this naturally affects search results and useful addresses along the routes. Also, distance units setting kilometers, billions, or automatically costs privacy. We allow you to use services to save travel history. You can supply additional information, basic services, other functions, and so on. You can allow the application to continue running in the background and reset the settings to default and if we need it accordingly, and delete downloaded maps and votes. That is, make the program as if it had just been installed.